Guys, keep that going for Suzanne King. Thank you.
I heard somewhere that some people would say that that right there is just proof of God himself. You listen to that and you go, where did that come from? Where did it come from? God did that. And that's all you can do. All right. Anyways, Psalm 63 was written by David when he was in the wilderness of Judah. And it's called The Thirsting Soul Satisfied in God. O God, you are my God. With deepest longing I will seek you. My soul, my life, my very self thirsts for you. My soul longs and sighs for you in a dry and weary land where there is no water. So I have gazed upon you in the sanctuary. I see your power and your glory. Because your loving kindness is better than life, my lips shall praise you. So I will bless you as long as I live. I will lift up my hands in your name. My soul, my life, my very self is satisfied as with marrow and fatness. And my mouth offers praise to you with joyful lips. When I remember you on my bed, I meditate and thoughtfully focus on you in the watches of the night. For you have been my help. And in the shadow of your wings, where I am always protected, I sing for joy. My soul, my life, my very self clings to you. Your right hand upholds me. And now, Eva Schoolcraft.
Drink with me. When the dust of daily toil becomes noticeable, drink with me. When your throat is dry from putting things back in order, drink with me. When your sorrow is unbearable, drink with me. When you think yourself unlovable, drink with me. When your hands are full and your heart is laughing, drink with me. When all your troubles seem invisible, drink with me. Drink with me, for wine is both a doorway to hard truths with indelicate honesty and a highway to gladness with dances of joy. These things are the feasts of my table. Drink with me.
Sweeter than the honeycomb, richer than the wine, better than the finest things we can taste this life. You are my desire's king, love is all I'll ever need. You are my delicacy, so come on, come on to the dinner table. Come on, come on to the dinner table. You're healing my heart when I'm drinking in you, like jumping in the water in the summer of June. Soothing my soul when I'm feeding on you, like eating mama's cooking in the afternoon. Now is the time to feast, now is the time to feast. Taste and see, taste and see. The Lord is good, good, good to me. Earthly goods and they'll fail you every time. You are my desire's king, love is all I'll ever need. You are my delicacy, so come on, come on to the dinner table. Come on, come on to the dinner table. You're healing my heart when I'm drinking in you, like jumping in the water in the summer of June. Soothing my soul when I'm feeding on you, like eating mom's cooking in the afternoon. Now is the time to feast, now is the time to feast. Taste and see, taste and see. The Lord is good, good, good to me. satisfaction. You make man's heart happy. Wellspring of life. I'm here to die. I'm drinking in you. I'm jumping in the water in the summer of June. Soothing my soul when I'm feeding on you. Like eating on spoken in the afternoon. Healing my heart when I'm drinking in you. I'm jumping in the water in the summer of June. Soothing my soul when I'm feeding on you. Like eating on spoken in the afternoon. Now is the time to feast. Now is the time to feast. Taste and see. Taste and see, the Lord is good, good, good to me.
This song is called Take This Slowly. It's kind of an inner monologue reminder that our God is good to us, that he takes care of us, and that our idea of time and a long time are not the same as his ideas, but we know that our God is good and that he'll take care of us. But sometimes it feels like things are going slowly, but our God is good and he'll take care of us. Took all that I got and spread it out on this table, it might not seem like a lot. A once glimmering joy slowly fading from view. All the change in my pocket, it's not enough. And this picture of you. Still I've heard all that I have in a moment is hardly a sign of everything coming my way. I believe when I need it, it will be mine. So let's take this slowly. All I need is coming, but it's just beyond what I can see. So with my eyes pressed forward in fierce alarm, just turn my head back to see how we got. It's far and I'll be all right. Coming my way, I believe what I need, it will
So let's take this slowly. All I need is coming, but it's just beyond what I.
A bunch of scripture verses here about how awesome God is, and God created everything, and God made the heavens and the earth, and God made the plants on the third day. We already read that, which I did not know when I started this thing. But the more I watch this video, the less I want to say about it. Because one of the reasons I love gardening is because you can't actually do anything in gardening. You can't. God has made the seed. Yeah. God has made the seed according to its kind, like we read in Genesis chapter 1. And then he provides the light and the rain. We can help out a little bit, but that's just really being faithful. Being faithful is not any of the power of making the seed grow. We have nothing, no power to make a seed grow. We can't, come on, seed. We can't do anything like that. So at the end, I'm going to read something, just a verse out of 1 Corinthians 3:7. But I'm going to watch this with you because I'll watch it for the 26th time. And it's still awesome. I mean, just watch. This is what Paul said in 1 Corinthians. He said, "So neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth." Think about that. And you can watch that like 100 more times. He's got other videos, but it's really fantastic. When we realize that we don't have the power, God has the power, and he exercises that power in his loving kindness toward us. And next up is Eva Schoolcraft.
The opposite of debauchery is not a black and white table, strictly laid out with foods chosen for their nutrition, yet sterilized of all culinary joy. The opposite of debauchery is not anywhere that people sit down stiffly and reflexively obey archaic fork laws. The opposite of debauchery is not pale, adorned with only dusty words, overly perused to the point of misunderstanding. The opposite of debauchery is not men stacking up arguments for the continuing of statutes worn thin. The opposite is not attacking the art forms of countercultures or making impotent copies. Love, boy, there is Christ. Wherever is found, there and thinking a place where for a moment soul flies freely, knowing full acceptance and abundance of creation.
This night, as we've been looking at, we read through Genesis 1 at the beginning of the evening, and God just kept making things until until everything was good, and everything that he made was good, and then he just filled this whole world with good things, like all the fruit that we saw being grown, all the vegetables, all the plants that we saw being grown, food for us to rule over and to cultivate, just more than we could ever imagine or think to ask for, our God has provided for us. And yet, there's a tension, and that tension is that for some unfathomable reason, sometimes that's not enough for us. Sometimes this lavish display of generosity is not enough for us. And it takes a miracle of our God dying for us to make us into a new creation that can actually say, "Our Father, you are all we need." And we celebrate that miracle, all together tomorrow for Resurrection Sunday. But you know, we live in that miracle, and that's why we're here tonight. So, this next song in particular kind of acknowledges that tension, that phenomenon of being outside of a party thrown by your father and not wanting to go inside. It's called In the Middle.
I can hear the music, but I don't want to come inside. I never let you down before. How could you go and give away my prize? I'm still in the middle, I'm still in the middle, I'm still in the middle of my only life. I'm still in the middle, I'm still in the middle, somewhere in the middle between grace and pride.
This is our last song this evening. We're not done yet. Even after we finish the song, we can still go worship through eating pie, which is one of my favorite types of worship. I like singing, but pie is great.
Come to the water, you who thirst, and you'll thirst no more. Come to the Father, you who work, and you'll work no more. And all you
soon. Love is here. Love is now. Love is pouring from his hands, from his brow. Love is near. It satisfies. Streams of mercy flowing from his side. His love is.
is pouring from his hands, from his bow. Love is near, it satisfies. Streams.